get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
In order to accommodate the entire dynamic range of this experiment, the sound mix was adjusted to reserve the necessary headroom. You may find the average level of the video lower than usual as a result of this. For the full experience, adjust your level so the speech sounds comfortable. The sound mix is available for Patreons as an uncompressed download on the producer level tier and above.
Okay, so I want to grab a track here with Van Morrison. I always dig this track a lot. From the Avalon Sunset album. It's called Whenever God Shine His Light. And I'm not a religious man at all, but this track can sound amazing and it can sound very tinny and shitty, depending on the system. Usually I'm never really satisfied with it. It has a rim shot that can sound almost like a bullet or something like that, or a bit fluttery. But sometimes it actually sounds like a rim shot, depending on the system. So, and has great voices, nice piano. Holy sound state. Listen to the body on that rim.
We'll never go.
I mean, I love this kind of neutrality in the sound. It's clear, it's open, it's detailed. Maybe it's because I've been a studio guy or working with sound for so many years that I really appreciate when I can hear stuff. But I don't want it, you know, pushed on me in an unpleasant way. And I love a great sound stage and all that, but I want controlled bass, clean controlled bass with no weird lumps or bumps. Let's see your face, Tim, when you hear this.
What we got?
If it's getting the Tim approval.
Baby face, yeah. In your face, yeah.
Into that, you have a lot of punch,
a lot of power, but nuances as well. There's tones within the tones. It's almost a sub bass without any discernible tone. But here you actually hear the notes being played,
yeah.
In the sub.
And you have no excessiveness at any point in any of the notes.
It's not bloated or boomy.
No. It's just really detailed. It's amazing.
Wow.
This is the and I gotta play this for Carsten. He always uses this track. This is Bob Dylan.
Hold on. So I'm going.
It's a great, great track. The man in the long black coat. Nice dynamics. Deep bass. Harshness at all.
Crickets are chirping, the water is high. There's a song, cotton bids on the line, hanging dry. The windows wide.
I never noticed the room the voice is recorded in. I do that here. There's a little boxiness in the top end of the bass in his voice, right? It's pretty crazy. I never heard that before, ever.
Yeah, it comes through on this.
Yeah. And the harmonica, the what is it called? The mouth harmonica?
Mouth harmonica, yeah. Mouth.
Extremely smooth presentation. Yeah. Also goes for Bob Dylan's voice that has this harshness in this recording. Yeah. And the air between the elements in this, it's like huge soundstage. It's crazy. I never heard it like this before. It's like everything is being pulled a little apart to create air and enjoyment around it. It's crazy. We got to continue with something else.
I don't understand how they much get that much treble and detail out of one little treble unit each side.
No.
It's a ribbon tweeter and a small cone.
It's some amazing driver units.
Get so much out of it.
Let's go back in time and see if Frank will appear before us.
When you're smiling.
In the flesh.
When you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, when you're laughing.
I mean, this is insane. I'm really, really, really surprised about this system. I heard this system at trade shows and things like that. Weren't that impressed, a little thin sounding and nothing. I wasn't excited. But this is the best speaker system I have heard so far. And I'm not saying words like that lightly. Okay, I was very much in love with the Dali Epikore 11. Remember that, Tim? Great speaker, right? This is on another level. But we're gonna find the flaws here. There must be something that, you know, there must be something that is wrong with it, right? Now I'm gonna listen to some opera. A great 2L recording, by the way. The sound staging, guys. This system, it has the headroom and dynamic capability, so it just feels so unrestricted in the way it delivers the sound. It's really something. You don't have the sense of any boxiness at all. It's like it's just not there, okay?
It feels effortless to it.
Totally effortless.
It's whatever you throw at it, yeah, fine.
It's amazing. Let's check out the punch. Remember the big Genelecs?
It's in control of unbelievable forces. The moment you lose respect for this, it can, and it will, destroy the only body part you care for as audiophiles. You got that, maggots?
Oh, yes, sir!
Good. So let's do some elite listening. Shall we, gentlemen? Mount up.
Yep.
We had in the Dream Speaker reviews.
The big scary Genelecs.
Yeah, the big scary ones. This system has a lot of power as well, right? So we got to do the Quality of Mercy with the pissed off lady called Michelle Schacht. But this recording, it really has some punch to it. Hear the tape noise? Again, the sense of space is gigantic.
Oh.
temple seeking gain. All your senators and lawyers with your motives to explain. All your victims and your heroes, your petitions to complain. All your murderers and martyrs on the fields where you lay slain. On the just and unjust, alike it doesn't rain.
It just blows my head off. It's amazing. The sense of space and the sense of stage you get here, that must be what the dipole does for you, right?
I guess so.
Yeah, it must be. You look forward to get this chair, if you can rip it out of my cold, dead hands. We've got to hear something old as well. It's really important. I mean, I will find some old 70s stuff. This one you heard before in a big hip-hop hit called California. Not many people know that this is Joe Cocker, my friends. I'm sure that the studio engineer that did this track, he would be surprised, or she would be surprised if they heard it on this system. It just adds so much dimension that, whoa, did we do this?
And the details as well coming through. Yeah. They say the tape is coming up and
Oh my God, it's good. It's really good. Okay, so what happens with some of that nasty, dirty, filthy, bassy stuff? Let's start up Lawn here. I mean, it kind of raises the eyebrow a little bit, going, what are you doing? Doesn't it?
Do you mean this? Yes.
Yeah, you mean this? I'll do it.
If you want me to, I'll do it.
Yeah, I'll do it.
You tend to give them the benefit of any doubt. You think, if they sound harsh, it's because the recording was harsh.
Yeah, yeah.
If it sounds boomy, it's because the recording was boomy.
Exactly. I mean, but it actually sounds pretty well, but you can hear it. This was done on some much smaller speakers,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Yeah. But there's control, there was no real surprises.
No.
It's just the speakers, the way it presents music, this holographic sound staging,
yeah.
It really doesn't do that well with these kind of recordings, I think.
Maybe it's
we usually hear something really dry, kicking in your face. You get a bit softer, smoother presentation here, right? Mm-hmm.
You get an awful lot of clarity, and maybe that works against it in some of the more dirtier stuff.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, the acoustic stuff just feels so right.
Yeah.
I mean, when you hear a horn or something playing here, now I'm grabbing some 80s electronic pop music.
Yeah.
Is he Italian?
No, I think he's British guy. Scooty Politti.
Pretty ready? Screen. But it's tight. It's tight as a mother. You gotta sit here.
You're
enormous.
Ain't that fantastic? Okay, let's see what else I got on this playlist. If you like experimenters, check out the experimenters playlist. Boom. Yes, sir. For more speaker reviews, check the speakers reviews playlist. Schmuck. And the awesome dream speaker reviews. Blam. And may I also suggest that you check out the HIFI news and quick reviews episodes that contains all kinds of advice, ideas, including music suggestions, rants and interviews, and HIFI business news also collected in a playlist here. Slam.
Ladies and gentlemen, here comes the AV therapist himself.
Sæt dig, Ubo. Sæt dig! Sæt!